A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th October, Sunday. On the front page you have NRC a legal process, says Modi. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi again assured Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina on the issue of NRC at meeting in New Delhi. So it has been said that it's a legal process. And earlier we have seen even External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar saying that it is an internal process of the country. Then here you have news of clashes in Mumbai's RA colony on Saturday after activists tried to stop the felling of trees for the metro project. Police said 29 persons were arrested for staging a protest without permission and assaulting two constables. Then below you have 50 MLAs inspect 25 km of roads each. So this is in Delhi that members of Legislative Assembly inspected roads. They identified total of 1,897 problems in 1,260 km stretch of Delhi city. So this is a, and this is green crackers will reduce pollution. So this is regarding green crackers. CSIR, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, said it has developed and brought to the market green crackers that by its own assessment would reduce particulate matter pollution by 30%. So CSIR has signed agreements with 230 companies to manufacture the crackers and make them available for sale. So here you can see the apex court is going to take a decision on these improved crackers, green crackers, which are expected to reduce levels of barium nitrate pollution as such. So if they have reduced levels of barium nitrate, then they are called improved crackers. Potassium nitrate and zeolite are used in these crackers. So these crackers are tested also. They have been tested. They have been developed by NERI, National Environmental and Engineering Research Institute, which is a CSIR lab. And here you have Jammu and Kashmir is India's internal issue. So this is Maldives president Mohammed Nasheed. He has said that his former president of Maldives. He has said that Jammu and Kashmir is India's internal issue and Maldives cannot align with OIC, Organization for Islamic Cooperation, on this issue. So OIC, we had seen, had given directives to Indian government about on Jammu and Kashmir after Article 370 was revoked. On page 9 you have RA is in lockdown as trees are felled. So section 144 has been imposed here and 29 protesters have been arrested. Early in the morning on Saturday, nearly 200 adherents have been detained through the day. So they were protesting against the felling of trees at RA. Actually, the government has plans for a metro car shed, and that is why trees need to be felled here. Out of the 2,646 trees that are to be removed, 2,238 trees are slated to be cut, and the rest are planned to be transplanted. So there are thousands of trees have been cut here at RML colony. And this is Thanjavur idols to be returned to temple. So these are statues, big temple's property is what the idol wing has said. So these are two idols of Veenadhar Dakshinamurthy and Tirupuranthagar. So they are going to be placed at Shri Brihadeshwar temple. It is said it is there where they belong there. On page 10 you have in New Delhi and Dhaka failed to ink deal on river waters. So agreement has been signed to share data on ports for improved connectivity, but on river waters the agreement could not be signed. So this was we failed to sign a framework agreement to optimize the use of waters from six rivers, that is Manu, Muhuri, Khowai, Gumti, Dharla and Dudhkumar. So these have been discussed for several months, but no agreement could be signed. So here you can see the two leaders have directed officials to complete the six river agreement as well as feasibility study of Ganga Padma barrage project as part of upgraded version of 1996 Ganga water sharing treaty. On international page you have Saudi Arabia, Iran work towards talks. So Saudi Crown Prince asked leaders of Iraq and Pakistan to reach out to Tehran for de-escalation. So there are tensions going on. Saudi Arabia and Iran have taken steps towards indirect talks to try to reduce the tensions that have brought West Asia to the brink of a war. So we had seen that drone attacks were alleged by USA also, that Iran has conducted these drone attacks on Saudi, you know, and see, you can see the pipeline being damaged here too. So, President Donald Trump's refusal to retaliate against Iran after the September 14 attack as such has resulted in these now Saudi Arabia prompting to seek its own solution to the conflict. And here you have Trump signs proclamation to block visas for uninsured. So immigrants applying for US visa will be denied entry into the country unless they can prove they can afford health care. So this is a proclamation which has been signed by President Trump. But the rules will not apply to those seeking immigrant visa from the rules will apply to immigrant visa seekers, but not to those already residing in US, and also it will not affect lawful persons, permanent residents, and does not apply to asylum seekers, refugees or children. And here you have on Hong Kong streets protesters defy mask ban. So despite the mask ban, protesters came out with masks, and here you can see how they are being restrained by by the police here. And this is US North Korea nuclear talks are broken down. So earlier there was a small news item that they are reviving talks, and now this is another small news item that the talks have broken down again. And this is regarding Iraq. We have seen how the toll has risen every time it comes in news since the last few days. So Iraq remains tense. Protesters without any political backing, they have been protesting on the streets against unemployment and corruption here. And now the and police has been firing at them with ammunition, and death toll here has risen to 81. So top officials met protest leaders to discuss their demands to now. And this is Taliban US envoy meet after impasse over deal. So we had seen how Taliban had also gone to Pakistan. They are in Islamabad, and even US peace envoy is in Pakistan. So they met, but then US officials have ruled out any peace talks. There is no important news on international on business page. So next is on Sundays you have this FAQs coverage, frequently asked questions. So issues which have been prominently in news over the week are discussed here in detail. So here the first news is who gets to own the Nizam's millions. So this we had discussed in detail about the case for 35 million pounds now, which was going on in UK High Court, and the ruling was given. It was actually 1 million pound, but now it has, you know, increased to 35 million pounds. So why did it take so long to resolve, and how is Pakistan involved? So entire detail is given here, which we have already discussed as well in news in the weekdays. And then here you have citizenship flare-ups. So this is regarding citizenship amendment bill, why government is pushing for this bill, and does it go against Article 14 of the Constitution. So this is very important, and you should know about it. Citizenship amendment bill, it aims to give citizenship to minority communities from Muslim majority countries. Means to, it plans to give citizenship to Hindus, Sikhs, Buddhists, Jains, Parsis and Christians from neighboring countries, Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan. That is it. So this bill has been protested against, especially in Northeast, because the NRC exercise does not distinguish between religions. It is looking at illegal Bangladeshi or illegal migrants from be they Hindus or Muslims. But this bill is trying to give the citizenship to Hindu illegal immigrants. So they will become legal citizens. So that's the process which is allowed in this bill, and it has been protested against. And here you have, how will purchases from Russia affect India-US ties? So India wants to buy these S-400 Trump missile system from Russia, and USA has said that we'll impose sanctions against any country which buys such defense equipment from Russia under the CATSA, the new law of USA. capsized, countering American adversaries through Sanctions Act. So that is detailed out here. So that has been in news for long now, for months or a year maybe. So this you should know about. Then on Sundays you have science and technology coverage. So here you have IGIB finds a protein with better precision in gene editing. So this is researchers from Delhi based Institute of Genomics and Integrative Biology. So they have discovered a protein variant from a different species of bacteria that can edit the DNA with very high precision. So presently the tool which is used commonly for gene editing is CRISPR-Cas9. So Cas9 protein behaves like a molecular scissor that cuts the DNA at a specific location and inserts a foreign piece of DNA to correct the mutation that causes any disease. So new protein has been found by IGIB for gene editing. Then below you have India is home to Asia's oldest bamboo. So two fossils dating back 25 million years have been found in Makum coalfield in Assam. It's the oldest bamboo fossil, Asia's oldest bamboo it's called. And this is ISER Pune team synthesizes photocatalyst to degrade organic pollutants. So these are researchers from ISER, which is Institute of Science, Education and Research in Pune. So they have successfully converted the highly unstable perovskite into a highly stable photocatalyst capable of decomposing toxic organic pollutants commonly present in water. So this is the development here, you can see. It's a photocatalyst, means it is activated by sunlight. Then on Sundays you also have dispatches coverage. So this is regarding international news over the week. So this here, first news is regarding elections in Afghanistan. It is said two candidates have already claimed lead while the result of Afghan polls are yet to be released. So that is fine. We have discussed about Afghan presidential elections and the results will come. So there will be news again. You don't need to go through this. This is in the name of God. So this is regarding blasphemy law in Pakistan. It said already 1472 people have been charged under the blasphemy law It's in Pakistan since 1987. So this is regarding this issue. Asia Bibi issue of a Christian woman who was on a death row for blasphemy and was acquitted by Supreme Court is in specifically a point which you should know. It was prominently in news. Her acquittal had triggered mass protests in Islamabad. And this is capping the refugee intake. So this is US government which has limited the number of refugee admits for financial year 2020 to 18,000. Which is the lowest since 1980. And this is regarding Bangladesh. It says Hasina's crusade against corruption. So Bangladesh Prime Minister has launched a drive which he says is necessary to address rising inequality in the country. So this is about how Bangladesh is trying to fight corruption. So that is it. These are the news items. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.